everybody, and welcome back. Today we are in conversation with Professor Upendra Bakshi, who very kindly granted us the time to discuss some important topics which will help a lot of you. Professor Bakshi is a Padma Shri awardee. He was also the Vice Chancellor of University of Delhi, and most importantly, he is a doyen of jurisprudence, which is why today we are discussing with him the concept of grand norm. Grand norm is a commonly asked question in all exams, be it law, judiciary, or any competitive exam. So without any further delay, let's get into it and let's ask Professor Bakshi his thoughts.
Well, thank you. I'm sorry it has been so late in getting together, but I do not think I can guide the young people, but I can always misguide them. So that's that they should take me a pinch of salt. Jurisprudence, I always say, is consists of three things. One is legal theory, other is legal philosophy, and other is a French also use the word jurisprudence, but they mean by jurisprudence the decisions of the courts, the highest court and the court of Cassation and others. So you have, and the fourth is the distinctively American innovation, which broadly they mean by jurisprudence legal policy. So there are three or four dimensions. Now, legal theory, nobody does in India. Legal theory is, for example, exemplified by H.L. Hart. By Dworkin, by many other people who are around in US and UK. Legal philosophy is particularly a continental affair, where they consider the ends of the law, the purposes of law, whether law is necessary at all. They're so accustomed to the idea of there being a law and state. But these people go behind that question to ask the underlying question as to whether there is any such thing as law and what the nature of it. So legal philosophy is a kind of legal theory branch, but it's different. Legal theory is a theory of concept of law and concepts of law. Concepts like property, possession, personality. Take ideas that law succeeds with or runs away with. Whereas legal theory is about the nature of law. So there are two ideas, nature of law. Legal philosophy is cognate, but it's different. It's similar, but it's not quite the same. So there are many ideas of law. First thing is whether law itself is necessary. And in this field, the most contribution, valuable contribution, is made by people who were called philosophical anarchists. Anarchist does not mean what the police mean by it. People are seditious or treasonous. Philosophical anarchists are people who doubt the authority of authority. They ask questions where the authority comes from. And this is, Dennis Lloyd has done a very nice book in Penguin called The Idea of Law. And the first chapter, very simple, Idea of Law discusses the contribution of the philosophical anarchists. Again, I repeat, not anarchists, but philosophical anarchists, who say, why order, why law? And unless you know the answer to those questions, or work out some answers to the questions, you can't proceed. Because fundamental assumption is the idea of law. So there are a number of people whom the law discusses. There are other people who do legal theory, and that is the idea of law. And you asked me the question about Kelsen. Kelsen is the person who founded the idea of grand norm. And the idea was simple. The idea was that let's consider law as a series of steps in ladder. And after all, there comes a point beyond which there is no step. Right? At that cut-off point is the basic law. Any system of thought, he said, not just law, should have a final terminus, cut-off point. A cut-off point is not arbitrarily set, but it is when you don't have any more step. The ladder exhausts itself. You can't climb anymore. Like people climb the Everest. Beyond Everest, nothing. You have to presume nothing in order to give the peak of the Everest, the height you give. Otherwise, beyond, of course there is beyond, but then beyond cannot be explained. Or take the example of a child, an infant child, 2 years child, small child, say to parents, why ought I obey you? And the answer is, well, darling, you must obey it because we say so. Why ought to obey what you say or I ought to obey? And you say, because your parents have seen many Christmases, wiser people. You must obey your parents. And the child asks, why should I obey by what you think is good? Parents are saying. And then say that it's good for you. And the question is again, why should I follow that? It's good for me. And ultimately, you keep on saying, and then you come to a point where you say, God says so. Because God has said so. That's why should I ought to follow God? At what time? At that point of time, what do you say to the child? Nothing. That's the basic law. So similarly, or you slap the child for being insolent, or it's a bad method, bad parenting, in my opinion. So you have in all systems of thought a cut-off point beyond which you can't go. In Hindi, it is put by that actor in Akhrosh as a senior lawyer who says, "Tum mere vajay ki vajay poochte ho." Junior lawyer पूछता है क्यों ऐसा क्यों होता है मैं क्यों होता है आखिर में वो बोलता है व्हाट इज आई कैन नॉट आंसर यू आस्किंग मी द कॉज ऑफ कॉसेस दैट आई कांट आंसर सो इन कल्चर्स आइडिया इज प्योरली वन ऑफ मेथड दैट समवेयर देयर मस्ट बी रेस्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ थॉट बेसलाइन नॉर्म इज अ नॉर्म दैट यू प्रीसपोज टू बी वैलिड of which, whose validity questions you cannot ask. You have to presuppose some norm to be valid in order for the legal system to be valid. Well, the Indian constitution, for example, it's a grand norm. Now, somebody like the child in my story says, well, look, why should I, ought I to obey the constitution? Then you say, because it was given to you by history. At this point of 70 years, it was there. American was 200 years old. Then you ought to say, why ought I to obey that one? To that question, there is no answer. So you can go to 35 Act, Indian Independence Act, passed by British Parliament, say 35 Act, then 1919 Act, then the charters of the East India Company. Then you go back to Dharmashastra. Now if you say, why ought I to obey that? There is no answer to it. So there has to be a cut-off point. Otherwise there is what is called in logic, infinite regress. And you cannot think if you regress all the time.